Hey everybody, it's Teresa at the Empty Armchair, and today we are at Old Sturbridge Village. And here's a little map of what it looks like. But this is one of our all-time favorite places to come here in New England, and we're actually here today to check out the fall foliage, which is not that good right now. We had a really bad summer where we had pretty much only 4 weekends, I think, where it didn't rain. So the trees don't have the best of color this year. They're pretty muted, and we had a storm come through last weekend. A lot of the leaves are gone off the trees, but we're going to try to share what it looks like so that you can enjoy it and to give you a sense of what New England was like. Old Sturbridge Village is set up as an 1830s village here in New England, and the buildings are all original. And it is located obviously in Sturbridge, which is close to the center of the state, next to Worcester, Mass. And so anyway, we're gonna walk around and show you what it's like, and hopefully you'll be able to enjoy it. So anyway, wish you were here. Next time you're here in Massachusetts, come to Old Sturbridge Village. Okay, thanks, bye. Thank you.
day.
Hello.
Good morning. To our cabbage shop.
Yeah, beautiful.
I'm
it normally isn't open. We don't normally get to see this one.
It's always open.
Maybe they're break when we come.
I mean, they may have been on lunch break. Yeah, but it's staffed every day with maybe occasionally someone's sick.
Tables.
A few things, yeah. I made some stools. I helped make the winter chair. Someone else made the tables, so.
Gorgeous,
yeah. What are you working on now?
Making a little maple box out of some maple I found. That has some interesting figuring. Though it's hard to see in this light, but it's got a neat look to it.
Oh, that's cool.
It's going to have a sliding lid. It'll be kind of a smaller version of this candle box that I made out of
candle
pine.
Boxes, those are great.
Yeah, those very are common. Great. Yeah, keep your candles safe from mice. But those are very common, and the pine ones like this, you know, pine is a nice wood to work with. It's cheap, it's common, but it's not the most interesting looking. So that would have typically been painted or stained or veneered even. Whereas the maple is a more interesting looking wood. And these are all for woods. The cherry was very popular for furniture around here. Other things were used. So
very nice.
A little harder to work with.
So all kinds of wood chips inside and leaves outside.
Thank you.
But it is a staff and it's sweet
because it was so wonderful seeing
sure
her
is. Yeah.
Made.
Yep.
And whoever was here, you or one of the other ladies, they'd explain, well, this is what we had in that period.
Right, strange. Right. And so actually today we're talking blood sausage, which. But if you look on the map guide, you're trying to offer more when you're here of like Tom Morehouse. You've probably seen under a lot of it. This is a simple breakfast. I would love to have some pie on the plate just to talk about the fact that pie was something that was a side dish in our time, and it shows up on your breakfast plate, it shows up on your dinner plate, and it you might have it cold for supper. So pies are pretty ubiquitous. Grinding coffee down, we've ground some coffee, we'll be making it on that, putting on some hot coals.
Thank you. Well, no, but it was the first one that actually got off the ground. First of all, investment is terrible when, like, your investor is 3 months ocean journey away. Like, people die on the voyage, and then your investor dies, and you don't have any money. So it's very volatile, this industry over here. But also, in the 1615s, they tried a little further south in Virginia, but the local indigenous population did not like all these smoke belching off of these charcoal pits, and something they didn't want to see done. So they just either something happened, an altercation happened, and they essentially eliminated that problem from their lives. So it was like just a volatile industry. So by 1642, though, it's the second but the first successful one to be established here, major manufacturer. And the reason why we want, you know, the Pilgrim story is great, and I heard that in school, and that's awesome. And there were people coming here for the religious persecution angle, but almost every single one of our colonizing cultures that kind of inhabited this land wanted a place where they weren't trashing their own country to make metal, because Europe has been scalped of all the, especially in England, scalped of all the trees to make charcoal so they can make iron. And so they bring over settlements that could help make iron. In fact, institute the Iron Act, which says, no, you can't make your own iron products. You have to ship it back to us, and we'll refine it, and you can buy stuff from us. So it was this efficient system of them using resources from a different continent to make the metal to ship back to them, and then they can make money off the colonists. What an awesome scheme. And this isn't just England that's doing it. It's kind of all of the colonists were using similar strategies, because bigger, there's more abundant resources here, or just more of it. The one thing that we don't have, which is really important, is tin. So there's no tin plate being made in this country because it's too expensive. You have to ship it over here. So England's got kind of a corner on the market there, because the only tin mines are in Cornwall and Afghanistan, but I don't think that they had access to that at that point.
Oh, yes.